Hello, in this video we are going to talk about the Hirschberg test, also known as Hirschberg Corneal Reflex test or Hirschberg sign. This test consists of observing the position of the light reflections on the cornea when we project a point light. In strabismus, this test allows us to obtain approximate results of the deviation of the visual axis. It's very useful in children, eccentric fixation patients, where cover test is not applicable, uncooperative patients, patients with neurological problems, and patients with very poor vision such as deep amblyopia. This test also allows us to easily differentiate a pseudostrabismus from strabismus. In the photos above, we can see two cases of pseudostrabismus, epicanthus and hypertelorism. The epicanthus can simulate an esotropia and the hypertelorism an exotropia. We see the reflections correctly placed, although it may seem that the visual axis is deviated. In this case, the test is negative and confirms that they are patients with pseudostrabismus. Seeing the photos, we can diagnose a pseudoexotropia in the case of the epicanthus and a pseudoexotropia in the case of hypertelorism. With this test, we can also diagnose strabismus or pseudostrabismus through photos taken with flash. In the case of old photos, it can help us to date the time of evolution of the possible pathology. It can also help us in the cases of patients whose parents report that their children sometimes look away. If their examination is normal, we may request photos in which they have seen a deviation in their gaze. Through these photos, we can help these parents and diagnose if there is a real deviation or it is a case of pseudostrabismus. Julius Hirschberg was a German ophthalmologist. In 1886, he developed the Hirschberg test for measuring strabismus. Hirschberg calculated that each millimeter of deviation corresponds from the center of the cornea towards temporal or nasal at approximately 7 degrees and about double measured in prismatic diopters. A 4 mm pupil is assumed to be normal. Procedure. The patient must not be pharmacologically dilated. Emmetropic patients must be with their adequate optical correction. In emmetropic patients, it will be performed without optical correction. We must use a spotlight bulb, the retinograph or a flashlight can be used. We must place the light in front of the patient, focusing on the nasal bridge. The normal scanning distance is between 30 cm and 1 meter, and the patient must look at the light source. When the two reflections of light on the cornea are congruent or centered, the patient is in orthotropia, is normal, without strabismus, like in the picture. When this is not the case, one of the reflections must be centered, because we are asking the patient to look at the light. Then he will look at the light with the dominant eye, with the fixing eye, and this dominant or fixing eye will be the one with the centered reflection. The deviating eye is the one that will have the reflection at some other point. If the reflex tends to go towards the outside of the eye, it's because the eye is deviating inwards, therefore will have an esotropia. It is important to remember that the positive Hirschberg test, the eye reflex will always deviate in the opposite direction to the axis of strabismus. In the same way, if the reflex deviated towards the nasal side, it is because the ocular axis is deviating laterally. In this case, we must diagnose an exotropia. In the hypertropia, the visual axis of the one eye is higher than the fellow fixating eye. The ocular reflex of the deviated eye moves an inferior direction. Hypertropia is the similar condition, focus being on the eye with the visual axis lower than the fellow fixating eye. The ocular reflex of the deviated eye moves in a superior direction. Well, what are the approximate results of the deviation of the visual axis according to the position of the eye reflex? If the reflex is within the papillary rim, the maximum deviation is 15 degrees, which is when the reflex touches the papillary rim. If the reflex is within the patient's iris and is not dilated, we have not performed a pharmacological mydriasis, the deviation will be around 30 degrees. If the reflection of the deviated eye is on the iridoscleocorneal edge, on the edge of the cornea, the deviation it will be about 45 degrees. In this test, it's important to remember the next. The patient must not be pharmacologically dilated. The eye reflex will always deviate in the opposite direction to the axis strabismus. The eye with the centered eye reflex will normally be the dominant eye. Tests allow us to easily differentiate a pseudostrabismus from a strabismus, and is very useful in uncooperative patients. Thank you very much for your attention.